Right, turn.
Thank you.
Two things. We are talking about a very small minority. We are not talking about freedom fighters or idealists. Nothing of the sort. We are talking about thugs. We are talking about extortioners. We are talking about torturers. We are talking about murderers. And of course, we are talking about cowards. In fact, we are talking about the scum of the earth. The sacrifice of our magnificent musicians will not be in vain. Our fine band service will play on, and we will emerge stronger and more determined than ever before to fight and destroy this foul and dark force for evil.
Thank you. course, one's first reaction to what happened last Friday morning was of total shock and horror and disbelief that such a thing could happen. But then very shortly after that, one became very much involved in all the many, many things that needed to be done. So all of us have been very busy indeed, 24 hours around the clock since then. But my one abiding memory of Friday afternoon, when I first arrived back in Deal from Portsmouth, where I was when the atrocity happened, was of meeting the surviving members of the staff band. And through all that shock and the numbness that obtained at that time came the one strong determination that the thing that we needed to do was to get back onto the road as soon as we possibly could and to do the things that we do best. And that is what we were doing this Friday morning in the march through Deal. When the members of the staff band came back into work on Tuesday morning, I said to them, as far as I was concerned, the march had a threefold purpose. First of all, it was to be an act of therapy for us all, because it's what we most needed to be doing. Secondly, it was an act of intent to show the world that the Royal Marines Band, whatever else happens, goes on doing the things we're famous for doing. And thirdly, it was an act of defiance to whoever committed this terrible deed, that nothing but nothing that they can do would stop us, and that therefore, despite an event which they might consider a victory, it was in fact a failure, because they have made us, and I believe the rest of the country and the rest of the world, more determined that they should not succeed in their dreadful aims.